One element added to a film after production is the music, provided by gifted composers like Jerry Goldsmith.
This is where it all begins. All the electronics. They all help, but I'm gonna start somewhere. I start the piano, as I have all my life. I try an average 2 minutes of music a day. It seems like that isn't very much, but you'd be surprised how much, how many pages 2 minutes can take in a fight or a chase. And so the film has an hour of music, one figure, that's going to take the 2 minutes a day. It's going to take 30 days to write it. And that's basically the way I figure it. And that it takes maybe a week to record the music. So you're talking roughly 5 to 6 weeks, because the period of gestation of getting the approach, the theme, and all that could take a week, 2 weeks. I mean, one never knows. I can't come out to the garden here and pick it off a tree. I mean, if I could find one of those trees, I'd really stock, I'd make a nursery of them. So one really figures that I think the average time I spend on a film is maybe 6 weeks from beginning to end.
Composer Jerry Goldsmith has written many hours of music for more than 125 major motion pictures, including Chinatown, Poltergeist, Lilies of the Field, Patton, and the Oscar-winning score for The Omen. He recently finished the music for Poltergeist 2.
The music is adding a character to the picture, both psychologically and emotionally. And for the composer to be in tune with the filmmaker, it's what we're both trying to accomplish together, is the major number one task. The next one is to come up with a musical interpretation of our discussions and our ideas, and how to make the music as a piece of architecture within the film itself. It's just not scattered pieces of music in the film, but it's all related thematically, and it has to be tied together. I'm surrounded by all this high-tech equipment, and I've been asked a lot of times, when you have all the state-of-the-art electronic equipment, how can you seem to use one of these antiquities that probably goes back to antediluvian times, the moviola, when we have the high-tech fast ability of using video? And my answer to that is really, I guess, the romantic thing is, I like the feel of the film. It's still a film medium we're dealing with, and I like the stack of film, and I like the clank of this thing. I mean, it makes a hell of a lot of noise when it goes. I mean, and if it doesn't break the film, which it does have a tendency to do every once in a while. And it's noisy, but it's film. I want to do something I have never done before. But for me, the most important thing is character. I mean, I think that's what music does so well, and I think the thing I do so well is to get inside a character. I think, you know, probably as far as I'm concerned, the best thing I ever did in that nature was Patton. And that's wonderful. I don't like to write about machinery. I don't find a lot of emotion in it. You know, I use a certain amount of high-tech stuff in what I do, naturally. That's our time, but it uses an application to get inside people and characters. That's what drama's about, are the people, not the environments. It's how they react to all these things. And that's what I like. I became very fascinated with electronics. I guess the first time I really got involved was in 1962 when I was doing Freud. And John Huston wanted the dream sequences in there to be done all electronic. The electronics now are virtually a part of our, you know, our whole society now. They play such an important part. And in music, it's part of it now. I don't think that we can, you know, deny their existence. I don't want to. I find that it gives me a whole new palette. I have a whole new section of the orchestra. I'm not using them to put musicians out of work or to save money. I mean, I still use an 80-man, you know, piece of orchestra, but I'll have three keyboardists who may be playing a variety of 12 different synthesizers. The more that the director knows where you're coming from and what you're doing, the more likely it's going to be accepted. And before we used, you know, I'd sit down on the piano and try and play something. And I hear things in my head. I can say, well, strings are playing this and the brass are playing that. And the director can look at you and say, oh, sure, I understand. But they haven't the vaguest idea. Now, I'm going to show my director and producers the one of the new things I've written for Poltergeist. That's going to use that sort of electric piano sound for an accompaniment. And then I'll probably put the melody on this. A little whistle sound. And then perhaps, let's see, I want to get a little string sound in here. As you can see, the whole logistics of putting all these together wouldn't work very well. And that's where the computers come in. Now, all I have to do is say, fellas, this is what I've just done. Hope you like it. And I... And through the magic of computers, there it is. I always loved drama. And I always wanted to be a composer, so it seemed that the two of them would go hand in hand. So it's something I love, I've always wanted to do, and I always want to continue doing.